no mistakes. When he sheltered me with your heart, there's no safer place than to be in love. And here I will stand. And there ain't never, ain't gonna never, ever leave you.
No matter what the people say, I'm gonna love you anyway.
No matter what the people say,
I can't let you go. Even if we fuss of mine,
even
try
if we
till we get it right.
Oh,
you are my life, I can't let go. Even if we disagree,
even
you
if
can
we
put
disagree.
It on.
No matter what.
Pillow Talk time. I'm Glenda, the Good Witch, here with my beautiful co-host,
Erica McClean.
Erica McClean. Welcome, everyone. It's another Pillow Talk here at RMC On Air, Roscoe's Media Center in La La Land, Los Angeles, California. And tonight we got a nice little show. I'm a little loopy loop already, and I haven't had not one drink. But we're gonna have a wonderful time tonight. We have a wonderful guest in studio, Tawani. Am I saying that right, Tawani?
Yes.
Tawani Price, from Zuri Wine Tasting. We'll be on shortly, and a friend of mine is hanging out with us as well. And so tonight's show is Sexy Spirits, and we'll get into different wines for various romantic occasions and the upcoming holidays. And so that's going to be fun. But first, we want to get into our weekends and a little pillow talk of the town. First up, congratulations to our very own Erica McClean.
Yay!
Erica won the Crossover Award at Night Moves in Tampa, Florida, the Night Moves 2012 Awards for her song, Riding the Flying Pink Pig.
It's actually called Pink Pussy by Snoop Dogg wrote.
But I guess they couldn't put that on there or what?
Well, they put for Riding the Flying Pink Pig is the movie, but okay. But they said for a crossover song for Snoop Dogg and Erica McClain. So and he wrote and gave me a song for my movie.
Yes.
Yes, and it's perfect because it really is fun. It's an honor and a blessing to have that song. Thank you, Snoop Dogg.
We won. I know. You guys won. That is outstanding. Congratulations again.
Thank you.
So tell us, honey bun, how was the weekend there?
It was porn stars and strip bars, and it's going to be a great documentary. We did some interviews, and I interviewed some strippers, and then we watched them on the pole. We also followed the porn stars who were my friends, my family, around Tampa and the bars, and a little behind the scenes, and then the award show itself.
Yeah.
It's going to be fun. It's going to be a great special for TV, and we're making it. We're doing it right now. We just had a post-production meeting and getting everything lined up to start editing, and they have hours and hours and hours and hours to edit, but it's going to be great.
Yeah.
Strip bars and porn stars.
Strip bars and porn stars.
It's Night Moves Award Show 2012, Tampa, Florida. So it was the 20th, and I was on radio station there. It was WDAE. It was a sports radio.
Okay.
And they're big fans of Snoop. And anyway, I was on there promoting with two of my girls, and we did great. And so we had like different stars, different porn stars going to different radio stations throughout the 4 days that we were there.
Right.
And so like every night it was at a different bar, and then, you know, and during the day we followed them. And then the last day was the award show, which was really fun. But the day before that was Fan Fest. And I actually have fans that came up, they bought videos, they asked for my autograph, they took pictures of me. I thought it was a big honor. I loved it. So it's like, oh, it was really, really great. I had a great time, and it was like something they just added to the show at the last minute, but it was pretty packed, actually.
Yeah.
Did well. I think it was great because, I don't know. It's just everybody wanted to buy the video.
Right.
So it's great.
Did you have a good time though, babe, right?
I had a good time. It was long hours. It was like up in the morning to do the interviews. And then like, you know, of course the bars closed 2-3 and then we were still filming afterwards.
Yes.
Because that's where a lot of the fun is as well.
Right.
So I brought my camera people, and there were four camera people, but two actually were my guys, and they worked like crazy. They never stopped. And I'm glad that I brought them. And Alex Plank and Noah Trevino, thank you very much if you're listening. It was. They had a ball because they do documentary different style. This is a documentary on the industry.
Okay.
So I brought them into, you know, strip bars and porn stars. Fun for the weekend.
Fun for the weekend.
It was my weekend.
Yeah.
It was good.
So, and you got back yesterday?
Last night.
Are you feeling? Are you feeling okay?
Oh yeah, I feel good.
Okay, good.
Yeah, I feel good. Excellent.
Good. Well, so. I'm so happy for you, babe. Congratulations.
Thank you.
I saw your pictures and I thought, oh, they're having such a great time.
It is great.
Yeah.
And actually my next movie I'm gonna be starting in November. I won't tell you which house I'm gonna go under, but I'm starting that, and it's an all black cast, maybe one or two Latinos in it, and maybe one token Caucasian, but it's coming down the pike.
Cool.
And a mainstream film, too. So probably by the next show, I'll be able to talk about it.
Okay.
Oh, and we should give a shout out to Debbie the Glass Lady.
Yes.
So, Debbie, if you're listening or if you listen to this afterwards, thank you for the cup. I haven't gotten it yet because I had a production meeting. I wasn't able to see Bishop, but I will stop by to get it. And I lined up a photo shoot with it with one of my favorite photographers. And I have a special little surprise for you. So Glenda and I are conjuring something up.
Yes, yes, yes. Debbie the Glass Lady. She's well known throughout Chicago as well. And she makes the pimp cups and the blinged out chalices and wine glasses and champagne flutes, and I've known her for a number of years, and interestingly enough, Debbie the Glass Lady blinged out my wedding glasses.
Perfect.
Years ago, and so I am very familiar with Debbie the Glass Lady, and she does amazing work. And
we're doing something for breast cancer awareness.
Oh, really? Yes,
because
it's breast cancer.
But she has, you know, background with, you know, with when a background, her background comes from like breast cancer and mm-hmm. and other people in her family. So it's kind of like a tribute. And she made me a special one. Bishop bought me my first pimp cup, which I love.
Yes.
And Debbie's making me a new one. She made a new one. It's called the Bride's Cup.
Okay.
And it has a dress that comes off of it. So we're going to do something special for you, Debbie. Glenda and I are going to make
cool.
it rock.
Yeah,
we're going to help
great.
Breast cancer, Debbie Double D cups for breast cancer awareness. We're going to rock it for you. We love you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Erica. I'm so glad. Like I said, I'm glad for you.
Thank you.
Excited for you. Congratulations
you.
Again, Honey Bun.
Thank you.
So, in addition to Erica's entertainment news, we're going to a little pillow talk of the town. So, if you have been living under a rock, then you are unaware of the fact that Chris Brown and Rihanna are supposedly, allegedly, or I guess you could say, yeah, truthfully, back together.
Yay, I knew that was going to happen.
You predicted that, Erica.
I did.
You predicted that, and I was just like, I was afraid to say yay or nay. You know, I try to kind of, you know, I try to be neutral about it. But Chris went on a lightweight rampage, but a little drunken video fit about his love of both Rihanna and Kariuche. I don't know. Does anyone know how to pronounce this girl's name? Have we ever heard this girl say her own name? I don't know.
Kariuche.
Yeah. And so he went on to say how, you know, basically he broke up with Kariuche through a online video saying, you know, that he didn't want to hurt her or, you know, cause her any pain with his friendship with Rihanna. And since then, he and Rihanna have been spotted together. Since then, Kariuche have expressed her displeasure about the fact that he chose to do that in the public eye. And I can understand, you know, that's embarrassing. And it's, you know, it's no one's business, basically. You know, I think he could have handled that a little differently. And I feel bad for I feel bad for her. But I have to admit that I'm glad that he and Rihanna may be trying to, you know, work things out.
Mm.
You know?
Me too.
So we'll see what happens next. And what else? In other news, Reggie Brown. Who does Reggie Brown play for? Is it the Saints, I believe? Don't get me the line. KJ, who does Reggie Brown play for?
Reggie Bush.
Reggie Bush. See, I have no business even reporting on that in the first place. Is it the Saints?
Is that Kim Kardashian's? Yeah.
Yes.
It's the Saints. It's the New Orleans
Yeah,
Saints.
It's the New Orleans Saints. That's a shame.
And maybe his brother
and now
is.
He's not even with the Saints. He's with the Dolphins.
Yeah, he's Dolphins.
Okay, anyway.
He's some football
he
player.
And his girlfriend, he and his girlfriend are expecting a baby. He and his girlfriend are expecting a baby, and he was on a very popular radio show right now. I can't recall the name, but he sounded so happy talking about the fact that he is expecting a baby. He sounded over the moon. So when our expert, Twani, comes on, we'll have to, because she's going to, you know, describe the different wines for different romantic occasions. So I want to know, what kind of wine do you take when you slit your wrist? Because we need to suggest that to Kim Kardashian, because I know she's about to probably have a fit that this man is going to have a baby. And his girlfriend looks like her, kind of favors her a little bit. What is that about guys who date girls who look alike? Like, Carrie kind of favored Rihanna, and Reggie Bush's girlfriend kind of favors Kim Kardashian a little bit. So
sometimes guys do that. Has anybody ever dated you and said you look like somebody or next or somebody famous or?
People have told me I look like somebody famous, but I have dated a guy who I did favor his ex-wife. I dated a guy. I don't know how old I was. 20, 21. And years ago in Chicago, and this guy I dated, everyone said I favored his wife. And I recall one day I took a picture from his out of his room. Y'all know when he ain't in the room, we go through their stuff. So don't even play like I'm the only one that does that. So he wasn't in the bedroom one day, and I took a picture I found. It was just right there for me to take in the back of his drawer underneath all of his underwear. So, you know, I mean, it was right there. You know, so I had to take it. So I took it, and I showed my mom, and the girl at the time, the girl had on some sunglasses, and she was sitting in a lawn chair, and she had on these really cute sandals with a big flower. Y'all know the little flip flops with a big flower on top of them that everybody wore. And I said, "Mom, look," and she looked at it and she said, "Where you get them flip flops from?" My mom said that. I said, "Mama, that's not me." She said, "Who was that?" I said, ex-wife. She said, "Oh, my goodness." My own mama didn't even realize that it was not me. She thought it was me.
Wow.
So, yeah, I think guys, like, when they have a type or something, they tend to date the same look.
Same type.
Yeah,
I had that.
Same type. Did you have that happen?
Yeah, I had. I was dating this guy, Bob, and he was a sports broadcaster. But there's this girl that was in Playboy at the same time I was, and her name was Lisa Pedriani, and she was a playmate, but she also did makeup, as I did as well. So people always say, "Oh, you look like..." And I remember saying to her when I met her, I said, we met and we had lunch and we said, "Do people say that to you?" She said, "Yes." And we both said the same story, because people would photograph us and say, "You know who you look like?" Or they would call us each other's name.
Yeah.
But I don't think we looked alike. But this guy he pursued me and we were dating. And then what kind of felt weird is we were at dinner with all his friends, and he goes, "Doesn't she look like..." with Wayne Gretzky and all his friends, it's all sports people.
Wow.
He's like, "Doesn't she look like my ex, Lisa?" And I thought, "Oh, that's a drag. Don't I look like me?" It's like,
wow.
Yeah, it's kind of like, really?
Yeah, and that's what I kind of felt too. I was like, he's on the rebound. He's dating me because I remind him of her.
Don't like that.
But he and I are really, really, really good friends today, and we're very close. And, so, yeah. So I'm like, okay, well, and at the time I was so young, and he was a little older than me. He was like 6 or 7 years older than me. And I mean, I was 20 or 21. So like 27, 28, I thought that was old.
Now it's just
a
baby.
I'm dating an older man. He's 27. Too funny. And let me see, what else is going on? Christina Milian, who is the Social Network she's in charge of social media for, I believe, The Voice, is engaged to be married. So
nice.
Congratulations, Christina. I'm thinking she just got divorced last year or year before. I'm like, she's moving fast. I need to catch up.
But congratulations to Christina Milian. And we're going to, what?
Danny DeVito?
Oh my God, yes. Danny DeVito and his wife, Rhea Perlman, are separated after 30 years of marriage. Can you believe that? I believe they have 3 children, 30 years of marriage. And for what? For what? Why? Why go through that? Why even announce that? Y'all don't have to tell nobody that. That's just too long to be married. And then now separate. And that's really sad. It really saddens me to hear that type of news.
Right.
And I think they met on the set of Taxi!
Oh.
Get in here! You only showed up because we had some liquor tonight. I know Erica told you we had some liquor.
I didn't even know you were in here.
Hey, baby.
Hi.
Lunelle is in the house.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Congratulations, Fanny. How are you?
I'm good.
I didn't mean to interrupt. Go ahead.
You are too funny.
Go ahead and bitch about what y'all was
doing. You better give me some sugar before I snatch the rest of that blonde off your head.
Mwah. 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 Hi, everybody.
Hi.
I'm just going to be over here in the car.
You're
no,
too funny.
You're
we're going to take a quick, we're about to take a quick break anyway. But yes, Danny DeVito and Rhea Perlman, that really hurts my heart to see that they're separated.
What is up with that?
That's crazy. That's crazy. I don't like that. That's sad. So we're going to keep them lifted up and hope that they work that one out because they didn't have to tell nobody that. They could have kept up to themselves. But, yeah, we're going to keep them lifted up in prayer and hope that they work things out. We're going to take a quick break. And when we come back, we have 20 Price of Zuri Wine Tasting is in studio with us. And she's going to give us some tips on some on the different wines for different romantic occasions and some good wines for the upcoming holidays. And my good friend Johnny is here from Hair Design out of Macy's. At Baldwin Hills Crenshaw Plaza. So my good friend Johnny is here. And Lunelle is in the house.
Yay.
Okay.
But she's popped.
She's Snap Crackle popped up. Snap Crackle
yes,
popped
is.
Up. Looking good, smelling good, looking like some good old good money. I love Lunelle's. I love her nails and her jewelry. That's so Chi-Town to me. That's like I wanna. That's what I would be doing. But I'm like, if I caught going to an audition for a tag commercial, they're gonna be like, "Bitch, what's up with all the rings and the jewelry and the fingernails?" So the most I do is just my little French tips because that's the most I can get away with without them saying, "Okay, now." Come on now, but I want to go back to my designs. You know, Lunelle, I'm a former licensed nail technician. I had a nail tech business in Chicago years ago.
Great.
So I'm always drawn to your nails. If you ever noticed that,
I cut them down.
I see you have because they used to be.
You didn't mention that.
They were Claudined out for a while, weren't they?
Yeah, for 20 years.
Very pretty. We'll be right back. This is Pillow Talk RMCOnAir.com Roscoe's. Media Center. We'll be back in a minute.
Your hands on my hips, pull me right back to you. I catch that thrust, give it right back to you. You're in so deep, I'm breathing for you. You grab my brakes, arch my back high. So thick, and you're so crown royal on ice.
ice, baby.
You're on.
Mm-hmm. We're back. Here in studio, RMC On Air, Roscoe's Media Center, here at Pillow Talk. Hello.
Hi, how are you?
I'm good, how are you?
I'm doing great.
In studio with us, Tawani Price of Zuri Wine Tasting is here tonight. How are you, Tawani?
I am wonderful.
Very good. It's good to see you again.
It's good to see you, too. It's been a while.
It has been a long time. I believe 2 years, maybe. We met at a Jill Scott listening party here in Los Angeles, correct?
Yes, and I was harassing people, telling them all about my wine business.
And I had you on my radar. I believe at the time I was at the Foxhole on Sheryl Underwood's show, and I could only get so many, you know, we was over there once a week, and a lot of people wanted to do the show, and I always had you in the back of my mind, so I'm sorry I couldn't get you over there.
No, I appreciate you keeping me in your thoughts.
Yes, there are tons of people that I have on my, what I call my hit list. Mm-hmm. One of them just walked in here. Lunell's in studio as well. Lunell's in studio as well. That rhymes. Hey, baby girl.
Hi. You're not really here.
I know. But Lunell, how can I say you not here? I can't sit here and say Lunell ain't here. Come on now. Let's be real.
She's a celebrity.
I know. I'm like, how am I going to sit here and not recognize Lunell? But Tawani Price, Zuri Wine Tasting,
yes.
Right?
Yes, I teach wine tasting classes. So a lot of people get confused because they think that I actually sell wine, and I don't sell any wine.
Okay.
I just teach people how to enjoy wine, how to appreciate wine.
Yes, because a lot of us don't know that. I have to admit, I'm not a huge drinker, so I am a novice. So I don't know. Oh, we got something in the glasses already.
What's that called when you're a wine?
Well, there's a couple different terms. So I'm a wine enthusiast. I'm not a certified sommelier.
Sommelier
is someone who goes to school and they learn all about wine.
Right.
And there's different levels of sommeliers. Mm. There's master sommelier, which is like the highest level. Mm. And that takes a lot of schooling. And they are pretty much winos for life. Well, I'm a wino for life, too. But they could look at a wine, taste a wine, and tell you exactly what region it came from, what year it is, and what grape it is.
Oh.
I'm not that advanced. Not yet anymore.
Oh, okay. Now, we're going to claim that you are.
I mean, being a wine enthusiast is good enough because I can tell you how to appreciate wine. And
right.
I really do help people understand wine and love wine. A lot of times my customers will say, I don't drink red wine. But then after I finish with them, they love red wine.
They love red wine afterward, huh?
Yeah.
And you started back in what, March of 2010? That was around the time we met, I want to say, because I think Jill's concert was back in 2010.
We met in 2011.
Oh, was it last year?
Yeah, because I have probably been on my grind for like a year.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Okay. And you're doing very well.
Yes, I am. Thank you
very
much.
I love your website. Tell us a little bit about how you got started. You have a funny story, correct?
I do have a funny story. So I'll try to make it short.
Okay.
I started with the wine tasting club with my girlfriend. That ended. I wrote a business plan, but I procrastinated. And when I met my boyfriend, I would always talk about my business plan. And he said, you should go for it. But I had young kids, so I really couldn't do it.
Oh.
And then in March of 2010, he made me really mad. He was in the doghouse for like 2 nights.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
2 nights?
Yes, 2 nights.
That ain't no doghouse.
That's a doghouse. You know how hard it is to
I was
talk
married for
person.
12 years. I know what a doghouse is. It ain't 2 nights.
Well, I was married for 7 years, and I don't like doghouses.
Okay.
So, yeah,
okay.
Two days is the max that I can put up with.
Okay, gotcha.
So anyway, I took that energy, those negative thoughts,
right,
and I turned them into something positive. And I published my business plan onto my website.
Okay.
And voila, my wine tasting business was born. 2 weeks later, I got my first customer.
Oh, cool.
And then after that, I was featured on Groupon that summer. And then I got a lot of customers.
I'm sorry, you said you were what?
I was featured on Groupon.
Oh, on Groupon. Yeah, I love Groupon.
And that was like shortly after Groupon had really first gotten popular.
Oh, yes.
So it was a really exciting time for me.
Is this like you go to different wine tasting or different events and you let people taste it? Or
so I do a couple of different things. My main product is my private in-home wine tasting classes. So I come to your house and I bring wine and snacks to pair with the wine, and we play fun games. And people usually have a group of 10 to 15 people, and it's really intimate, and you learn about wine in your own home. So that's one product that I have. And then I also teach group classes at different wine bars. For example, this Saturday coming up, actually, I'm teaching at this wine bar called Barsha.
That's here in Los Angeles?
Yeah, it's here. It's in Manhattan Beach, actually.
Okay, in Manhattan Beach. Yeah. Okay.
And so that's going to be, I call it Passport to Tunisia.
Ooh.
Yes.
Okay, well, let's get to drinking a little something so you can loosen up a little bit, girl. Loosen up and have some fun. You got your glass. Did you drink yours already, Lunel?
No.
Oh. Okay, so now you're going to explain to us different wines for different romantic occasions.
Yes, right, so what we're tasting right now is a Syrah. It's from one of my favorite places to go wine tasting.
Okay.
Santa Ynez, which is about 2.5 hours from here, they make absolutely the best Syrah in Santa Ynez.
And this is Syrah, meaning that is a class of wine, or this is just the name of this wine?
That's the name of the actual grape. So the name of the brand is called Zaki Mesa.
Okay.
But the name of the actual grape is called Syrah.
So this is, you don't like Merlot.
Oh, like a Merlot. Yeah. Like a
Riesling. You don't like Merlot.
Oh, you don't like Merlot. Like Syrah.
I love Syrah.
Okay. I love Syrah too, just because it has a little bit of spice to it.
Okay. And like, again, I'm not a big drinker, so I'm going to be taking baby sips, or I'll have this microphone down my throat. So
most important thing to do with tasting wine is take your time.
Okay, so why do people, they smell and swirl? What is, or they swirl the glass, and what does that mean?
Well, in my class, we go through all the steps, but we'll kind of just go to the most important steps right now. Uh-huh. What you want to do is you want to sip the wine.
Drinking it.
Sip it. And when you sip it, hold it on your tongue for a little bit. Let the wine meet your tongue. Hello, wine. Hello, tongue. Where have you been all day? And then you want to swallow the wine. Or you can spit. You can spit or you can swallow, whatever your choice is. After you swallow the wine, you want to notice if there's any lingering aftertaste or aromas. That's what you call the finish.
Okay.
The finish is how long the wine lingers in your mouth and your throat.
Okay.
So if you don't usually drink red wine,
my girlfriends have to finish my drinks. Like Erica has to finish. I usually will order a drink that Erica's gonna drink because she has to finish it for me. Because I don't drink a lot. I play grown up. I'm not really a grown up.
Well, and this is a grown up wine. So this is not your Moscato. Moscato is what I call your bad date wine.
Kool-Aid.
Your bad date
exactly
wine?
Exactly, Lunel. It's Kool-Aid.
Yeah, see, that's what I would have to drink.
And you have to see the legs, right?
The legs.
Right.
And you said something about the light. Something about light.
So you usually hold it up to the light. And when you're looking at it in the light, the number one thing that you're looking for is clarity. Wine should always be clear. It should never be cloudy. If it's cloudy, that means that it's flawed.
This is beautiful.
And then you're
too.
Looking at the color. Exactly.
Yeah, this is gorgeous.
The color is beautiful. It's just not your average purple. Like if you look at grape juice is just a flat purple color.
Yes.
But this has different complexities to the color. Like it has a light,
so it's a good wine.
Light outer, deep, dark middle.
Yes.
And so that's why you're holding
it up to the light. Yeah, light outer, deep, dark middle. Very nice.
Is this what you call a full body?
This is definitely a full body. It's
and what
full
does that
body.
Mean?
This is 14.
I don't know, I heard that someplace.
This is 14.5% alcohol. It's a full body wine, which means that when you hold it in your mouth, remember when I said to hold it onto your tongue?
Yes.
It feels full in your mouth. It feels heavy.
Hello, wine. Hello, tongue. Where have you been?
Where have you been? Right. So I compare wine.
Lunel, put that mic over there in your face, girl.
When I try to talk about the body of wine, I try to compare it so that people can understand it. So I use an analogy of milk. Think about milk.
Okay.
Pinot Noir is a light body red wine. Mm. So that would be like skim milk. Feels very light in your mouth, very light in color. It has the least amount of tannins, right? And then you would move up to Merlot, which
I'm sorry, the least amount of
tannins.
Tannins.
Remember when you were going,
Yeah,
makes your mouth feel dried out and bitter.
Mm-hmm.
That's the tannins in
the
red
tannins.
Wine.
Okay,
and
like
that sometimes will give people a headache, too.
No, not necessarily. A lot of people think that it's the tannins that give them headaches, but it's not necessarily the tannins. It could be... it could be the histamines in wine. That you know, a lot of people are allergic to histamines that are in wine.
When I drink wine, sometimes my nose gets stopped.
Exactly.
So it gets stopped up?
Yeah, it gets like
So you can have you could be sensitive to that. So you might want to take an antihistamine.
sure.
You might want to take it.
Chardonnay.
Chardonnay, Merlot and Chardonnay. The two most common everyday wines, yeah.
No, common girl.
It could be, well, you don't like those, though, so you're not common. Not you are common not common.
So if you take an antihistamine, would it make you, like, drowsy along with the wine because it's more of a relaxing thing? And antihistamine would have more of a relaxing effect, would make you kind of drowsy along with the wine? It seemed like a really weird combination.
Well, it probably could be. I'm not a doctor, so
you're
I don't
not
prescribe
supposed to take wine.
I don't prescribe that. I'm just saying, if you really like
I mean, that's something that I would do. You know what I mean? I'm an antihistamine wine.
I'll wash things down with wine, but you're
I really wow. like red wine. So if I wanted a glass of red wine, I might take an antihistamine just so that I can have my wine.
Well, let's talk about more of the wines like Opus One. Opus One is such an expensive wine.
Yes, is that why you want to talk about it?
No, not really.
We ain't got no Opus One in here, Johnny.
Well, I just want to know the difference between the effect of it, because she seems such a connoisseur of.
Well, of course she is. Well, it ain't Moscato.
Well, there's there's no difference in the effect of it. I mean, they're both going to take you to the same place at the end of the night.
Okay. All right.
But Opus One is so expensive, first of all, because of the brand name. It's like getting Wranglers from Walmart if you had like a Moscato, mm-hmm. a right. Two-Buck Chuck, mm-hmm. or if
a
you went
chuck.
And you had True Religions from Bloomingdale's,
yes.
you know?
Yes.
You're paying for that name. You're paying for the quality, too, because yes. True Religions are made a lot better than Wranglers, right? So Opus One is a really well-made wine.
Is that like you. So? Opus One is beyond Cristal. Is
I would say
it's probably
really?
On the same level as Cristal. Opus One is about $400 a bottle.
Oh,
Cristal.
Absolutely.
Is it a red wine? Is it Merlot?
That's a champagne or
no? It's a red wine. It's
a red
blend.
Wine.
So it's a blend.
Oh, so
it's
not a champagne.
It's a Bordeaux style blend.
Oh.
So it has Cabernet, Merlot, and
enjoy it very well.
And Cabernet. Mm.
So if anyone wants to send me a bottle of Opus One, RMC, on air.
Where do you buy your Opus?
In California.
Well, you'll find a wine
establishment. I don't know if they would have it at the Liquor Barn.
Oh, Liquor Barn.
Might have it there.
You
buy
it. What's that place in Manhattan Beach?
In Cotner.
What's the place? Bevmo?
Bevmo?
Is that the place?
Yeah, Bevmo is Manhattan Beach and in Torrance, all over. But Bevmo, Total Wines, it'll be in the glass shelf, though. You just can't go to the shelf and just grab
right.
it up. You're going to have to ask for some help with that one.
Okay, so, and this is a Syrah.
So this is a Syrah.
Okay, so let's talk about a little bit about what is this Midnight Merlot.
So when I sent you over the descriptions, I was just kind of giving you descriptions of wines for different occasions.
Yes.
And so the Syrah, for example, is your good date wine.
It's your good date wine.
Because it has 14.5% sexy, right?
14.5%
alcohol.
Alcohol, okay.
Yes. Merlot usually has about 13 to 14%.
Okay.
Too. Moscato has 5%.
And you said Moscato, the bad date Moscato. So a lot of us out here thinking we're doing something with our Moscato.
We just like to say it.
So, like I said, I'm not a huge drinker.
Sounds important.
You know, so tell me about Moscato and, you know, the meaning of, I guess, the level of importance when it comes to
Moscato is a very important grape. It's a very important wine because it's one of the oldest grapes and people all over the world drink Moscato. It's a very popular grape.
Gotcha.
But in the United States, it's become ever more so popular because of rap songs.
Like Alizé
back in the day, right? And, you know, Moscato is a good wine to drink. It's inexpensive and it's sweet. People
yes,
like it
is.
Because it's sweet and it has bubbles, right?
Yes, I'm not a huge drinker, so my drinks have to be damn near like Kool-Aid.
And
like,
that's what Moscato is.
And what's the other sweet one I drink? Riesling. Mm-hmm. I forever
Riesling.
Order. You don't like Riesling, Lunel? See, it's because it's so sweet. I have to
me
have that.
Me and Lunel have the same.
I drink Pinot Grigio.
Pinot Grigio. Yeah.
I like
that. I don't really do much red wine. If I do Syrah.
And Calagaista. Calagaista is a good wine. It's in the same...
I'm gonna have a wine party with
yes.
you.
Yes,
you should have
yes,
me over.
Have
the
one.
Holidays is coming up.
Yes,
and I'm gonna get Manly Hands to come over.
Ooh,
and I'm gonna get the wine.
Yes, yes.
Ooh, wine I'm gonna have to people. Stop working for a minute. They are fine, brothers.
That's a great idea.
Yeah, have Manly Hands and have you and have like 10 girls, and that's it.
at me.
Yes.
Well, yes. I said to him, girl.
So what kind of what kind of wine would Kim Kardashian have to slit her wrist since Reggie Bush went and had a baby by somebody else?
Oh my God.
Would she have a Moscato?
Kim is probably...
She would have Opus wine.
No.
Kim... She don't care. She getting ready to have Kanye baby, so she don't care.
Kim is probably at home right now drinking whatever somebody gifted her, some nice wine, and just opening up bottle after bottle.
She don't really drink that much.
Oh, she doesn't drink that much?
She does now, probably.
Well, she's hanging around with a rapper.
I know. But I don't know if Kanye... Well, Kanye, yeah, he's a drinker.
Well, not only that, because, you know... Reggie had a baby on her.
I know. That's tough.
That's fantastic.
I think
I'm glad
fantastic.
That he's having a baby. So I'm excited that he's having a baby. He sounded so excited, but I know that's going to crush
Is
Kim.
She black?
A
little bit.
She looks
black?
Like Kim. She looks like
she's
Kim.
White.
I think she's more mixed. She looks more mixed, but she looks like Kim.
She's not black.
She might be. Well, Obama's mixed. President
Obama's
mixed.
What do you have to do with? Don't say that. I'm leaving. I have nothing to do with Obama.
Don't go,
he's mixed.
I don't make jokes about Obama.
I just say he's mixed.
So we're talking about Kim.
No, we're talking about Reggie.
I like Kim.
Reggie
though.
And Reggie baby mama.
Yeah, his baby mama. Yeah.
I like Kim. I mean, I hope that she finds. I hope she.
I think her and Kanye are perfect.
We'll see.
Drink some wine.
Now what would you have Lunel serve at her Christmas gathering or her holiday gathering?
So what kind of ladies are these, Lunel? Are they like you, fabulous, or are they just kind of
mediocre? They would all be fabulous. plus, it ain't gonna be who you think is coming. I might have to do two or three because I got different sections of friends, you know.
Absolutely.
So I would have friends that already know about wine, maybe. Mm. Then I would have friends that would like to learn,
right?
Like with me.
Right.
Then I have friends that's kind of gully and ratchet that I need to bring them up to learn about wine.
We like the categories.
I like that too. I mean, I would definitely have, since it's the holiday season, sparkling wines.
Some
sparkling.
Oh, yeah.
Like different kinds of sparkling, like a rosé.
Oh yeah, sparkling.
And, yeah, definitely.
Now, what's the difference between when it shifts to champagne, which is a sparkling wine, mm-hmm. correct? At what point does it shift to not just sparkling wine?
But champagne?
Yeah.
So sparkling wine and champagne are the exact same thing.
Okay.
However, not all sparkling wine is champagne, but all champagne is sparkling wine. So champagne gets its name from the region in France called Champagne. Yeah. And for you to call a wine champagne, it has to actually grow in that region in France and also be made in the Champenois method, which means that they ferment it twice. The second time is inside the bottle. So the actual bottle that you buy is the bottle that they ferment the wine in.
Okay.
Well, I want to learn about this. This is really cool.
You can come to my party.
I want to be your guest.
You all are drinkers.
But I don't
want to
be in the
more.
What's the last one?
Yeah, but I don't drink wine. I drink liquor.
Liquor.
Yeah.
Wine usually makes me sleepy.
Yeah.
Oh.
Give me a headache. So I only drink wine if I'm like at a dinner party,
mm-hmm. yeah.
or if I want to get on the phone and do a bunch of phone calls. And
ooh.
You know, like drunk dialing.
Nice.
Oh, yeah, drunk dialing.
But I do that with wine.
So,
I'll get a glass of wine.
Drinkers can not have a taste for wines.
Right.
Just liquors, just hard liquors.
Some
drinkers.
If you're a cosmopolitan girl, a lemon drop girl, that's your before dinner drink instead of wine.
Right.
But, you know, you won't have... And then if you find yourself having wine and a cocktail, now you're drunk.
Right.
So... Yeah. You know, I want to learn more about wine because, you know, wine is better for your body than all
true.
The sugar in a lemon drop or a Cosmo or anything like that.
True.
I'm glad you brought that up because I just...
It's a social drink as well.
Right.
Yeah. It is.
You can have as many as five. You know, and still,
I want to draw out with you.
Well,
yeah. You drink
Johnny
good
came
wine
to your,
and you drink a lot of it.
Lunel, Johnny came with me to your birthday party.
I was
were
there.
You there?
There. Yeah.
Yes. I had a lot of not wine.
A lot of not wine.
Thank you.
Lunel, I'm glad that you brought up the health
sugar.
Benefits of wine because there was just an article that was published, Cedars-Sinai. They did a study and showed that women who drink moderate amounts of wine every single day, meaning 1 4-ounce glass glass of wine every single day reduce their chances or their risk of breast cancer.
Praise the Lord.
Yeah.
Ooh.
So this is red, and this is red wine. This is not Moscato. So yeah, if you drink, you know, red wine,
because it has
But red wine has all kind of antioxidants in it and resveratrol, and it's very, it's therapeutic.
Now, we understand that the wines are named, or the classes of wines are named after the grapes, right?
In the United States.
In the U.S.
In New World wine, yes.
And the others are named from the countries or the...
From the regions.
From the regions that grown in.
Yeah, correct. So you have Old World wine and you have New World wine.
Okay.
Old World wine would pretty much be everything that's in Europe, like Italy, France. Those wines are considered Old World wine, mm-hmm. and they name their wines after the region. So you have to know which grapes grow in which region.
I see.
So, for example, in the Rhone Valley in France, they grow the Syrah grape. Okay. So you're not going to see Syrah on the label.
Oh.
In Bordeaux, they grow Cabernet and Merlot. So you're going to see Bordeaux. So you have to know which grapes grow in that region. If it's a white Bordeaux, then it's going to be a Sauvignon Blanc.
Okay.
Nice. Do you drink wine? Is that what you only drink wine, or what's your favorite drink?
No. Oh, wine is definitely my favorite drink. Okay. But sometimes if I go out to... Lunelle, are you going across the street to the Comedy Store?
Yeah, I'm going all over the place.
For example, a couple weeks ago, I went to the Comedy Store, mm-hmm. and their wine was terrible.
Ratchet.
It tastes like tree bark.
It does.
And
it's
so,
the Comedy Store, for my
and so
God's sake.
When I'm places like that, I'll have a cocktail. Because I'd rather
have a cocktail. What would you drink?
Vodka.
Do you know what?
With vodka
I just changed my mind about my party. I think actually more men need to know about wine so they can actually pick a damn good bottle of wine when they take a woman out.
Yes.
Because men
idea.
Don't know how to pick a good bottle of damn wine.
Oh, so when you say you're going to change, you're going to have a unisex party.
No, I'm going to have one for just men.
Oh, just
and
the, for
me.
The men.
Oh, I like that.
That just sounds
men.
Great.
Yeah, because
be
men
at that
need
one
to
too.
Know more
that's
about
true.
How to pick a damn good bottle of wine.
That's
can
true.
We film it?
But the women, it's good for a woman. I guess I was going to say it's good for a woman to be able to impress a man. But some men, you know, they get a little intimidated that you know too much.
I already know more than a lot of men. So I wouldn't mind a man knowing how to pick a good bottle of wine, a good bottle of scotch,
right.
a great champagne.
Right.
You could have a unisex
well, you
gathering.
You can take me with you. What would I classify like?
You're in. You can come to both parties.
That's not fair, Johnny.
We're going to take a quick break and come right back. I forgot to give out the number, 323-965-1600. If you want to call in and talk to Tawani and ask her anything about her expertise in wines, please do. 323-965-1600. This is Pillow Talk, RMC on air. Roscoe's Media Center is where we be. We'll be right back.
Word on the street is you're getting this walking papers in. Well, I want to be the man that my daddy raised me to be. My mama taught me to be. See, baby.
That's who loves you more. That's who loves you more. That's who treats you better. That's who loves you more. About the past, this thing's gonna last. Oh, I wanna try this. I'm gonna rock you to sleep the right way. What I'm trying to say is, guess who loves you more?
I love you more. I love you more.
Side.
baby, you're perfect in my eyes. You're my joy and pride. Listen,
yes, girl,
here's why. Girl, I love you, 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 you.
Ooh,
oh,
oh. Here we go.
That's right.
I love this. I love Jill Scott's song earlier, Crown Royal, Crown Royal on Ice. That song is so sexy. It don't make no sense. So please, you all, pull up Jill Scott's Crown Royal on Ice and listen to those lyrics. Those lyrics are off the chain.
Wow.
I love it. And I love Raheem Devon's Guess Who Loves You More was just was playing just now. So we're back here at Pillow Talk with Tawani Price.
Hi, Tawani.
Of Zuri Wine Tasting. This has been amazing. My goodness. So tell me about how different wines, and please believe, know, and trust. Like I said, I'm not a big drinker, so if my questions may sound a little like, that bitch don't know that, damn, you know, so I don't care.
She's a 7-Up girl.
I'm a 7-Up girl.
I'm a Hennessy girl.
My drink is, what do they call it, a Roy Rogers, a Coke with grenadine in it to make me a cherry Coke. That's what I always order outside. Don't I order that, Erica, sometimes when we come out here?
100% alcohol.
Coca-Cola,
here at,
like
Bistro,
a cherry Coke.
Bistro on Pico here in Los Angeles is right out front here, so we usually go out there and have a little cocktail after the show. But Tawani, tell me about how different wines go with different foods. Like there's certain wines only go with white meat, fish, chicken. Certain wines go with red meat, you know.
So a lot of people think that there's all these rules when it comes to wine.
Oh.
And I like food and I like wine, so I pretty much break the rules and I drink what I love and I eat what I love.
Right.
But if you just had to have a rule, the general rule is your wine should either complement your food or it should contrast your food.
Oh.
So in my classes, a lot of times I will serve these chili mangoes that I get from Trader Joe's.
Uh-huh.
And they're very spicy with a sweet Riesling.
Oh.
And it's a yummy combination.
I need to write that down because Riesling is my drink.
Yes.
Chili mangoes?
Chili mangoes. If you go to my website, there's a Trader Joe's shopping list.
Okay.
And there's a list of snacks. They're just like snacks. So if you just wanted to come home and have on a Friday night, have a little snack.
Okay.
Like maybe dried cranberries with the Pinot Noir.
Ooh.
Those would be cute little snacks for, like, if you were on a
picnic. Massive diet.
A nice picnic. A nice picnic or... Shut up, Johnny. Or if, if
well,
you're...
Well, we as men need a steak.
Shut up.
What goes with that?
Hush your mouth. I'll take that microphone from in front of you with the fabulous lashes on.
Right.
If you have a guest over for the first time, like maybe like a first type date, not really a date because
well, you don't want to cook for him.
Right. That's just, maybe that's something that when he comes to pick you up and you invite him in.
Exactly.
And that's something you could serve him prior to you all stepping out for the night. And your site is Zuri Wine, ZuriWine.com.
Mm-hmm.
And I can find that list.
You can find
site?
The Trader Joe's shopping list on that site, and
okay.
You can also find different wines to pair it with.
Okay, okay. So like you said, they either can contrast
or they can complement
your dinners. So there are no strict rules, like
no
white wines
rules.
For fish and chicken and things of that nature.
Like for example, for Thanksgiving, I always serve Pinot Noir. That's the wine for Thanksgiving of my house. So if you come to my house for Thanksgiving or my mom's house, because that's where Thanksgiving is,
I'm there.
Me too.
Dare I not cook a whole Thanksgiving meal?
Johnny and I are cousins.
Okay.
Come on and come over.
So there.
But I'm in charge of the wine and the mac and cheese. That's what I do.
Oh, that's you're in charge of.
So the wine I usually pour is Pinot Noir, and that goes really great with a turkey dinner. It goes great. Turkey is a white meat, so people are surprised when I say a Pinot Noir because it's a red wine.
Right.
But Pinot Noir with a turkey dinner and a side of cranberry sauce is really, really yummy.
It's really yummy. Mm-hmm.
Well, tell me this. What would I have? I'm a really great cook, right?
And yes, he is.
We're going to your house for dinner.
I am absolutely the best. And when you're in the kitchen cooking, you don't want to like really go over the top with drinking wine or anything. You're cooking, you're making all these recipes, and you're putting things together. What is something that is more subtle, like when you're in the kitchen cooking? You see it on talk shows all the time on the cooking channel where they have like a glass of wine. And what is that that they drink that does not impair their...
You know what I usually do? I don't even worry about the alcohol content. Right. I usually just two glasses of wine and then the rest in the food. If I'm making a steak, two glasses of wine, and people were having Cabernet steaks for dinner.
Right.
Oh, nice. And I never realized, you know, that the alcohol burns off. I used to say, why are people, they would put, you know, the alcohol in... Now what about rum cakes?
Or vodka spaghetti sauce.
I know this person. Oh, gosh. She's going to kill me for not remembering her name. Oh. But E, she makes the best. All of her cakes are made with rum or some kind of liquor. And she has this technique of preserving the alcohol so that you actually get the alcohol in the cakes.
Wow.
They're so delicious. Her name is E. You should have her on your show. She'll bring you cakes.
Oh, I would love to. We'll have to find her.
I'll give you
especially for the holidays coming up. Right. Now, I had someone's rum cake one time. I couldn't even eat that shit. I said, you know what?
It was too strong. Too strong.
I said, I can't even eat this.
It was just like the ghetto rum cake. You
know what I mean?
Let me go to the nearest local liquor store and get a bottle of cheap rum and
batter. So even when it bakes, is that the alcohol burns off when it bakes?
You know what? I don't know because I don't usually. I usually drink my wine. I don't usually cook
it. Cook it with, because I always wonder, like, you know how they, you know, they have the brownies, you know, like for the 420 holiday.
Oh, those were
different.
So I always wondered, like with rum cakes, like, is that the same thing? I don't know.
I think brownies would go with like some. I think Pinot Noir. I think
brownies and
Cabernet.
E's,
this.
And Cabernet would be great.
And the young lady E, her cakes. You said she saves that. She can save that alcohol in there some kind of way.
And they're good. They're not overpowering.
They're
with
not
alcohol,
overpowering.
Because I'm not like a big. Right. Alcohol in my sweets, but it's good.
I love alcohol, to be quite frank with you. And I can tell you, like, with lamb, you know, beef, you know,
it's
red
wine.
Did
you go there with
the lamb? Lamb, beef, and so on. You would marinate certain foods in red wine, like when it's lamb, beef, or, you know, or pork.
Right.
And then with white wine, you would do something like probably a white wine with, like, chicken, fish.
I would do my pork in, like, a white wine, too.
Oh, you could do probably pork
because
it's white, you know, white, whatever. Yeah.
There was just one thing that I forgot to mention about my classes. Mm-hmm. So I specialize in my classes of featuring wines that are made by African Americans. I think that's really
wonderful.
Important. Because a lot of people don't know that African Americans are out there making wine, and there's about...
Yeah.
Eight different African American owned wineries in Southern California. In California.
Oh, that's
Southern
amazing.
California.
No, we don't know that. So, yeah.
Apple Valley is one of them, right?
Yes, Napa Valley is big.
Napa Valley has a few. Napa Valley has Brown Estates. Sonoma has Estrelina, which is one of my favorites. One of the owners of the wine. They're owned by a family, but one of the owners actually came down and talked to my customers and did a private tasting.
Wow.
And then the one closest to Los Angeles would be Rideau, which is up in Solvang.
Okay.
And
I take a wine tour
there every single month.
Oh, great.
Nice.
Wow.
So there are black folks making wine.
So, okay, what's another term? Corkage. What is corkage?
What is corkage? So corkage is the material used to close the wine. Cork is a natural material. It's actually tree bark.
Yes.
Right.
But if somebody says, oh, this wine is corked. So if you ever go to a restaurant and they smell their wine and they're like, oh, this wine is corked. That means that the wine is spoiled.
Really?
It will smell really bad. It'll smell like old tennis shoes, wet newspaper. And that happens to about 5% of wines. So 5% of wines that are closed with cork, they get this bacteria called TCA, and it spoils the wine.
So wouldn't they use something like cedar?
They use cork. Like, it's a tree that's grown in Portugal, and they use the bark from this tree.
It's porous.
And it's very porous, right? So I think that's probably why they don't use cedar, because this cork just naturally is a very good material for making wine. But some wines are closed by screw caps. A lot of wine companies are moving to screw caps, even for their fine wine. You can't judge a wine by its closure.
So how? Because I always think that they're really cheap.
What
if they
is
have
a
like
screw
the...
cap?
Hold on, hold on, Johnny. Eric, I'm sorry. What were you?
It's saying? Like because I see that too, and when I see it, I go, "Oh, this is not good. It has to be the cork."
Change right. your mentality. Change your mentality.
Right. Because I was just going to say
there
that.
Are a lot in New okay. Zealand, and I was almost going to bring them. I actually forgot them in my office, but I was actually going to bring a wine that's from New Zealand. And in New Zealand, 80% of their wines are closed with screw traps.
Really?
Mm. Yeah.
Okay.
That's interesting.
What else are we going to be tasting? Because I've tasted mine already.
I mean, I can
see,
go on.
You guys are done with yours. I can't finish mine.
Oh, I'll have wow. that.
Oh, here. Give me
here, pour that.
Like I said, ladies and gentlemen,
I my love that glass.
She does
alcoholic.
Not drink anything. 7-Up would be the best for her. As a girl's best friend when it comes to Glenda, trust dream. Me.
This is lightweight.
I get high off of life.
Oh, yes. And it shows in your beauty, darling. You have no debris in foreign matters circling around your face at all.
What does that mean, Dwight?
I know. I was wondering. I was like, oh, man.
Okay, the fumes, right?
I'm sautéed in
Johnny, I have to admit, Johnny made me feel so good earlier
she
tonight.
Have clean
I
it.
Was getting ready, and he was waiting for me to get ready. And he was like, oh, you look amazing. You look fabulous. I said, honey. I said, wait till I get some money.
She looks wow. so amazing. Wait, if I had the this? Money, I would give
oh,
it to
oh,
her.
Oh, wow. I had nothing. I said, oh, if I had something, Lord. Oh. Okay, I'm talking crazy after little sips.
Oh, baby. No more wine for
no
us.
No more wine. This was good. This was good. Thank you
absolutely.
So much for being here, Tawani. Thank you for having me.
Oh,
my goodness. It was my pleasure. My pleasure. I feel like there was so much more we need to know, but for now, this is good. We may bring you back as the holidays get into effect. Yeah. If you can find your girl, Eve. And when you both come back.
Oh, yeah. E is
because
awesome.
Because maybe you can talk about dessert wines a little bit.
Right.
And, like, what's a dessert wine? I thought, so can you not have it with regular food? Are you only supposed to have it with cakes and cookies? Like, what is a dessert wine?
And that's a good question because people are misled by dessert wine. So have me back and I'll tell you the truth about dessert wines.
Tell us a little bit right now.
Okay. First of all, they call dessert wines yes. not because you're supposed to have them with desserts.
Right.
But after Prohibition ended, they needed a way to tax wines.
Wow.
So they call wines that have more than the legal amount of alcohol, like 13% alcohol, they call those dessert wines so that they can tax them more. So if a wine has more than, it might be 13-14%, whatever it is, whatever that percentage is, they tax them more. So that's why they call them dessert wines. And they're usually, and they call them dessert wines because they're usually sweet, because you get sweet wines. I'll make this quick.
Okay.
You get sweet wines two ways. You either pick your grapes way too early or you pick your grapes way too late. When you pick your grapes way too late, what happens is to get wine, you get yeast and you get sugar. They meet, they make this baby called alcohol. If you pick them too late, they make a lot of love and they get a lot of babies called alcohol. So the wines have a lot of alcohol and they're super sweet.
Yeah.
So that's where the term or the notion dessert came from.
Isn't that something? It has nothing to do with actual desserts.
Right.
That's
exactly.
just like the Windy City has nothing to do with the wind.
It's windy in Chicago.
It has, but that term means it was back in like 1920s. There was some big convention in New York, and all of the different delegates from the different cities, you know, ascended upon New York, and the representatives from Chicago were very loud and boisterous and aggressive.
Right.
Thus, they were termed windy. Thus, we were termed the Windy City.
Like a
That's
bag
amazing.
Of wind.
Because
you
our
know
big,
what I mean?
Right, because our big mouths
big
and we're
mouths.
Aggressive. Aggressive and boisterous, and that's where the term Windy City came from. It had nothing to do with the wind.
Wow.
I didn't know that.
I didn't know that.
I didn't even know that. I'm from Chicago.
Yeah, that's what that means. Look it up. Look it up. That's what it means. That's what it means.
I love finding out stuff like that,
too. And I said that off of drinking alcohol, so I'm not that tipsy. Okay.
So,
but, yes.
If
but
you ever
you.
Go out to a restaurant and you order a dessert wine, get a port and don't order cheesecake or cheesecake with it. Order a cheese plate because it's going to be so sweet and so high in alcohol, you're going to need something to cut through that sweetness.
Well, you know,
you would get
I
cheese afterwards. You eat, yes, yes. It's very European.
Or you would use
yes.
more of a liqueur, like a Tina Marie.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Okay. There's a drink called Tina Marie.
Yeah, that's what is it? Not liqueur.
A liqueur.
Yeah, okay. Tina Marie LaCroix. You make cheesecakes out of it.
Tia, so not Tina, Tia.
Oh, Tia. See, I don't know. Yeah, I was like, Tina Marie, was she named after the drink?
No,
like,
that's,
I know that.
No, that's
I know
what it
Tina
is.
Marie, but she
was
like,
you know
Tina
what I'm
Marie.
Talking
yeah,
about,
yeah,
right?
I had,
you would make like, cheesecake and you would eat it with cheese, right. And that's what you would have with cheese.
Right, it's called T-I-A, Tia Marie.
Oh, not Tia, not Tina.
Not Tina.
Okay, I'm like, oh, we got square beans going on here.
I'm talking square beans to you, baby.
Tawny, thank you again.
Thank you, darling. You were
and we can find you where?
Thank you so much.
Zuriwine.com.
Zuriwine.com. Wine is complicated. We make tasting simple.
Yes.
Thank you. Thank you so much. You have Facebook, Twitter?
Facebook, Twitter. If you just type in Zuri Wine on the internet, you'll be able to find me. Or you can type in 20 Price and you'll be able to find Zuri Wine.
All righty. Johnny, thank you, Honey Bun, for coming in and hanging with me. And you are found here in Los Angeles at Hair Design at Macy's, correct?
Absolutely.
At Baldwin Hills Crenshaw Plaza.
Fabulous.
Do you do short hair?
Tawny says, do you do short hair?
I stand to be corrected.
He does short hair.
I do short hair, long hair. Makeup, lashes, everything.
Wow, I bet your makeup's fabulous.
Oh, my God. I know, right? I can totally transform you into whatever your fantasy may be.
Oh, nice.
Okay? And you will be able to reach me at Crenshaw Plaza Mall at Macy's.
Baldwin Hills Crenshaw Plaza at the Macy's at Hair Design. What's going on, Erica? What you got going on, babe?
Oh, well, I just finished. I'm working on a documentary. We're on strippers and porn stars.
Yeah, yeah, right.
And it's for Night Moves 2012. I just got back from Florida.
I just got back.
Oh, my Lord. And, well, we actually have male strippers, which is really great. And strip contests. Where else do you have that at an award show? So, and I'm getting ready to shoot my next film. And by next week, I'll be able to, let the cat out of the bag.
Yeah. Just again on your big
kitty
award
kitty.
This weekend.
Thank you. And thank you, Snoop Dogg.
Erica, your Twitter, Facebook?
It's Erica McClean, E-R-I-C-A-M-C-L-E-A-N, at Facebook me, or that's my website and my Twitter.
Yes, Mama.
Get it, Mama.
We also want to stress again, this is Breast Cancer Awareness Month. Breast Cancer Awareness Month is this month. So we want to make sure, ladies, that you get your checkups. And we want to increase awareness about this disease, in particular, breast cancer. So make sure you get your mammograms, get your checkups. Go to nationalbreastcancer.org for more information. We want you all to be healthy, live long lives.
And just relax.
And also order your cups from Debbie the Glass Lady. It's
Glass Lady.
Double D for cancer awareness. Debbie Glass Lady. You could go to my site and check her out, inbox her, or Glenda as well.
You can reach her through my Facebook. I'm on Facebook, Glenda Darnell, as well as Twitter, Glenda Darnell. Simply Glenda.com is my website. And we have 4 weeks from today until the election. Make sure all of you are registered to vote. There are some states that were, I think the deadline was today. If you go to my Facebook, Glenda Darnell, or my Twitter, Glenda Darnell, I did post and tweet those states, but I'm thinking, I mean, even East Coast, it's midnight now. So be aware that we have 4 more weeks left until the election. Make sure that you are all registered. You've former offenders, make sure if you are checking, make sure that you're eligible to vote. Don't think that because you have spent time locked up that you cannot. There are, you know, there's a statute of limitations, I believe.
I remember
that.
To vote Obama 2012.
Erica said to vote
just
Obama
saying.
2012. I said it too. Vote Obama 2012. Thank you so much. KJ, my honey bun is here tonight. He doesn't have school tomorrow.
Hello.
And thanks to Lunel.
How handsome he is.
Yeah, Lunel, thank you for stopping
in. Lunel,
hey.
We'll see you all next week here, RMC On Air, Roscoe's
God bless.
Media
yes.
Center. It's Pillow Talk. Good night.
Good night. Peace
Good
out.
Night, peace.
Good night.
Good night.
They can always tell